All right, so let's just go ahead and start the debate. We're continuing on Brian's property, and we've put our eyes on something that we put our eyes on even when we looked at the aerial image. We have a vast landscape here, probably 15 to 20 acres in four different units in close proximity that is cedar, eastern red cedar monoculture. And it's a hot topic debate, but we're here to remind everyone of what this looks like and the negative impacts it can have on the landscape. Sure, if I'm in the northern states,
yeah,
with heavy snows, hard winters, a evergreen thermal pocket like this would be very beneficial.
Maybe not necessarily in that size though.
Not
doesn't
in
have
that
to be
size
that size.
Either. Because you still have to eat.
Correct.
And this has almost zero forage value in this entire area that looks like this.
We're kneeling here because we wanted to showcase, okay, deer's level. This yeah. is, if they're going to bed down, this is what they're going to see. When they're moving through, this is what is, let's say, within reach or not within reach because there's nothing, right?
There's
nothing
cedar needs. You can see 100 yards this way. You can see 75 to 100 yards that way. You can see right through it from 4 foot and down.
And with 15 to 20 acres of a 220 acre farm, knowing some is pasture devoted to cattle production, this type of acreage is really eating into the overall productiveness, the value, the other diversity that we can offer and manipulate on this farm. So no doubt something's got to change here because fawns aren't being dropped and reared in here. Deer aren't choosing to bed down in here on a daily basis because there's not food. This is no sunlight, the void of sunlight at the forest floor. So
this is
low production.
Strictly pass through property, pass
yes.
through
acreage.
Acres here that aren't providing anything. And that's just crucial when you look at lowering stress levels, increasing body masses, increasing antler production. You have to look at acres and as many acres as possible, producing forage, producing cover, producing everything that a whitetail needs so it can express its full potential. And it ain't happening on a landscape that looks like this. And
there's a lot of landscapes that do look like this, but just don't be fooled by that. What you hear, there might be a snippet of a portion of a season where the thermal cover is beneficial dependent upon your region.
And you still have to have food.
Absolutely.
So you'd
Absolutely.
Be better off with strips of this with food close by of woody browse or other forage that can be obtained in heavy snow. But this in the amount and the size that it is here is not benefiting hardly anything. And it's important that we change management strategy to get this property well on its way to being the best property in the neighborhood.
That's right. And I know there's gonna be some people that ask, okay, I've got something that looks similar to that. Well, then what do you do, right? So
yeah.
What are we gonna recommend to Brian to be able to improve these acres? Well, with this size and this layout of these areas, some of these can be transitioned into food plot, right? This is pretty flat ground in
Very
here.
Flat.
And some other portions are too. So some of these can be dozed, cleared, and brush piled up, converted into food plot. But there's other portions. We don't need the additional 15 to 20 acres of just straight food plot on here. Although your gut may say to do that, think about native forages and think about cover. So in this one, what we're thinking about, because there is a cedar market in our area, and these cedars, and some of them in particular, are of size that we can make some calls, make some contacts, have them come and actually log some of these cedars and get them removed, and then manage the rest of them. Probably some additional felling of the smaller, less valuable ones. And at that point, we've increased the amount of sunlight and let the natives take off and go.
We know the seed bank is very diverse here. When you find the little pockets on the roadway that has sunlight, we've got the power line just out of here.
Yes.
It's got tons of natives, so we know that the seed is in the seed bank. It just needs sunlight, and so we just got to get these doggone cedars removed.
Absolutely.